you're headed to Yoga Barn. Cory and I have decided we're gonna do a 5-day stint of yoga and meditation in Central Bali, which is where it's known for. It's known for arts and culture and yoga and meditation, and we can't wait. So let's head on over there.
So Yoga Barn is about an 8-minute walk from where we're staying. If we end up doing those early morning classes, we won't have to go very far to get there.
It'll probably be a nice relaxing walk too. Kind of cool. Maybe, hopefully no, it won't be too crazy out here on the streets. Like you can tell it is now.
So guys, this is the path to Yoga Barn. It's kind of tucked away, but once you get there, it's almost like a little sanctuary. It's pretty cool. Let's go.
Finally doing yoga in Ubud. That has been a dream of mine, a bucket lister, if you must. I've always wanted to come here and do like a meditation, soul cleanse. Hoping to do that in the next 5 days.
So, as you guys saw there though, it says no cameras or video during class. So we'll just get a before and after for each class, but unfortunately during the class we won't be able to get anything.
So we just got our yoga schedule for our 5-day stint at Yoga Barn. This is a full day of classes. The earliest class is at 7 o'clock and goes to 8:30. The latest class is at 8 o'clock and goes to 9. We decided, since we are starting tomorrow, we'll take a vinyasa slow class at 8 o'clock. Then Monday, we'll do power yoga, which Cory's a little nervous about, but it'll be fine. Tuesday, a kundalini yoga class. On Wednesday, a hatha yoga. Thursday, fly high core yoga. We also decided that for our 5-day yoga stint, to contribute, we are going to eat healthier, so more water and fruit juices and more vegetables and fruit and less meat and carbs and sugar. Just being here makes me wanna be healthier in general. So I think this next week of yoga is going to be incredible for us.
No booze either.
Oh, no booze, yes.
So this means that our first class tomorrow is the vinyasa slow and it starts at
8 o'clock.
Just also wanna let you know of the prices here at Yoga Barn. We purchased 5 classes each, so that is 110,000 per class. That comes to about $7 or $8 per class.
Yeah, which really isn't too bad, being that Yoga Barn is so touristy and so very much on the map here in Ubud. $8 a class really isn't that bad. I mean, I remember wanting to go to yoga classes in the States and it was 20 some dollars for just one class.
See you guys at class tomorrow.
See ya. Good morning.
Quiet morning all.
Yes, very quiet.
We are currently walking to our first yoga class.
It's about 7:20 this morning.
I feel like I'm glad we started with the first day being a slower lesson.
Vinyasa slow. Encourages the student to connect to a softer aspect of yoga and take the time to explore the breath and the body as we flow through the physical practice.
Vinyasa slow. Warrior one, warrior two.
About your breathing.
Downward dog.
Ready for this?
I'm just saying yoga poses that I know, if you didn't catch on.
It is so peaceful here.
Good morning. First one's to class. We are about a half hour early.
Early bird gets the worm. All right guys, we are first to the class, but we're getting set up. So we'll see you afterwards.
All right guys, first class done.
I've done yoga before and it's usually hard for me to kind of let go and focus on my breath and my breathing. And this time I really just let everything go aside and was able to dig into my in your meditation?
I thought it was difficult because we had to hold poses and, you know, I got the leg shakes. Good first day.
Long class too, hour and a half.
Should be an interesting next 4 days.
Yeah, should be good.
Hey guys. Yoga.
Hello.
Yoga retreat, Ubud. Just wanted to give you a little update on our nutrient intake for these 5 days. So it is dinner. We are at a lovely restaurant called Atman with great healthy options on the menu.
Vegan, vegetarian, all sorts of things.
Mm-hmm. And we're overlooking this wonderful, could be rice field, could be something else, not 100% sure.
But it's very pretty.
Looks like a great place to have ourselves a nice dinner after first day of yoga. I actually ordered a Mexican burrito, no meat in it.
And I ordered a falafel wrap with spinach tortilla. Very vegan.
Mine is not vegan. Mine is cheese. And it's bomb. So, dinner was so good that I decided to get dessert. Some might call it cheating, but this is a raw vegan chocolate mint slice. I'm not sure if this can even be good, but we're gonna give it a try. It's kind of weird, but the mint definitely makes it like a dessert-y kind of taste.
You know, the mint texture, the spirulina in there, I don't know if that's what is giving it like a kind of a grainy texture. But you get mint and chocolate, and that's one of my favorite combinations, and I really like it. So if you don't like it, kind of the rest of it.
Alright guys, so that was Atman for our healthy dinner. What'd you think?
That's been one of my favorite places since we got here.
Definitely healthy. I don't feel bogged down by the food that I just ate. That is what we're going for here on this 5 days. So tomorrow is day two. We'll see you then.
See ya. Hey guys.
Day two.
We are currently headed to Yoga Barn.
Yoga Barn.
For our second class, which is power yoga.
Ashtanga style sun salutations and vinyasa throughout this class will clear your mind and really get into the nooks and crannies of your body and your practice. Our lineup of poses is diverse, focusing on fundamental asana of vinyasa.
Core power yoga, and it's gonna be rough.
We think.
It's a step up of difficulty from what we did yesterday. And I'm kind of sore from what we did yesterday.
I agree, I'm kind of sore as well. But it's kind of a good sore. It's kind of like, yeah, I used my body yesterday. Yes, it was a good workout. But I think tomorrow I'm gonna be even more sore with this next class. We just made it to class, 8:45. Definitely a lot less people than there were yesterday. So I'm thinking this is gonna be a little bit more intense of a class. We'll see you after class.
Sad, sad lady. So that was core power yoga, and it was intense.
To say the least.
There were a lot of positions that I couldn't fully get into because I'm not very flexible, and I knew that, but it was really realized today.
It was a lot about stretching and getting into certain poses and balance, which I appreciated, but there were definitely some very advanced moves that I could not participate in.
All in all, it was, for what we could do, a very intense class, and I sweated a lot. If I was wearing a gray shirt, it would be a darker shade of gray right now. We also got these drinks here. She got
ginger probiotic.
Ginger light. I got a Roselle ginger sparkling probiotic drink. Bubbles with benefits.
Probiotics. Actually do the stronger ginger.
Mine tastes like ginger ale with like a hint of berry flavor in there.
Mine tastes exactly like a ginger kombucha.
We'll see you guys tomorrow for day three. Hey guys, so it is the third day and we are changing our schedule up a little bit. Today we are going to yin yoga, which is kind of like a softer, more stretching and breathing type of yoga. After the first 2 days, we decided to go with this one as it's, you know, a little more of a break, but still completing our 5 days of yoga.
Woke up this morning pretty sore, so ready to just do a little stretching. Not as intense as what we did yesterday.
We are running a little bit late, so we gotta get there. Let's go.
Back to the class. Looks like people are filing in. It's much fuller class than yesterday. Ready to relax, stretch it out today. We'll see you after class.
All right, guys, so we just got out of our yin yoga class.
It was a really good class. We understood at first before we even came in that it was more about stretching and breathing. I had something in my mind about what it would be like. And then we got there and we're doing it. And it was something I think completely different from what I had imagined, but it was exactly what I needed. Walked in with a little extra raw emotion and some stress this morning, but after about 30 minutes, I was able to completely let go.
The class was really relaxing. I went into class with a lot on my mind, and it definitely took a while for that to go away. Probably longer than 30 minutes for me. Like she said, it was what we needed today, and I guess I learned today that yoga comes in all forms. It's not just, you know, the positions. It's also, you know, what we had today. Yoga Barn also has its own cafe, so we are going to go ahead and have lunch here at the cafe at Yoga Barn.
Okay, guys, so we just got our food. I ordered a vegetarian chili with tofu, and there's a little red rice here on the side. This looks fabulous, and the sour cream gods have blessed my plate. Cory got red rice nasi goreng, national dish around here, so it's very popular. But I'm gonna go ahead and take a bite of this. That's really good. Tofu is very soft, but I love the beans in it. And there's a lot of cilantro in there. And I love the taste of cilantro with that amazing sauce in there. So that'll do it for today, guys. We're gonna enjoy this and a fantastic meal, but we'll see you tomorrow for day four.
Yo, guys, day four. We are walking to Yoga Barn right now. Yin yoga has gotten me prepared for today, I think. I feel a lot better. And today we have hatha yoga.
Integrates the classical yogic path. This class honors traditional yoga and the culture it comes from in a medium-paced, easy-to-follow class.
So we'll kind of get a couple different flavors in this class. I almost wish that this was an earlier class. This is our only late class this week. Right now, our class today starts at 3:30, and we have been taking classes that have been early in the morning. So I don't know. I like the early in the morning classes. This, I kind of want to go take a nap.
Let's get to our studio. Hey guys, so we are at our hatha yoga class here. As you can see, we are in a different studio today than normal. This one is just a little bit further up in the Yoga Barn complex. Good thing we got here early because there are less mats here than in the other studio. But we're gonna go ahead and start stretching and get ready for our class. We'll see you after. Alright guys, hatha yoga has just ended.
I thought it was nice. The teacher was great. She tried to get us to understand the connection between body and mind and how to link it to our outside lives, and I liked it. I think she is what made the class for me.
I felt like there was a good combination of poses versus stretching versus just, you know, sitting there and meditating. There were some hard parts, as you can maybe tell. I sweated. That's a word. It wasn't as tough as like the core power, but it was still challenging.
For me, it was an easier class. I do have very intense lower back issues though. That seems to be a big issue with everybody, is lower back problems. So she was always kind of helping us along that way. So it was really nice. But it was easy. I liked it. I enjoyed it.
She also said something at the beginning that I kind of remembered. She said that your body realizes things before your cognitive mind realizes it.
I like that.
And that kind of made me think, like, wow, you know, sometimes your body is trying to tell you things and you're just not ready to listen to it maybe, but you know, it's always good to just listen to your body on how you feel. But it's 5 o'clock. We're going to go have a shower and then try and find some food, and then our class tomorrow is at 7:30 a.m.
Last class, day five. Everyone needs a cheat day. We'll see you tomorrow, day five.
Yo, guys.
Very busy morning here in Ubud.
Yes, day five. It is about 7 o'clock, 7:15 in the morning. We are doing Kundalini yoga this morning.
It is a beautiful and creative form of yoga.
brought to the West in 1969 by the late Master Yogi Bahan. It is fast, effective, and efficient practice, which allows one to feel centered, happy, and energized in as little as 3 minutes time.
My body has felt a difference for sure. I kind of feel sore again.
It's a bittersweet moment. I've really enjoyed it. But here we go, one final class. Hey guys, we just got to our last class, Kundalini. We're in the same classroom as yesterday. Nice and open to the jungle on the right side of us. It was really calming, really awesome. Let's get in there and get it done. Hey guys, so we just finished our last class, Kundalini. It was interesting. This was more chanting and more...
It was more breathing techniques.
Breathing.
The instructor, I felt like, had one of the best energies for the instructors we had. Not specifically that he was energetic, just he had very good energy.
Yeah, I could feel he was very passionate about what he was doing. What I really liked about it was we did a couple of chants in this class, and after the first chant, I've had trouble getting into this meditative state, and I'm gonna take Cory's words here, but it felt like I was floating afterwards. It was complete and utter just calmness. And I could like feel my body floating a little bit.
Kinda almost felt like I was the only person there.
And that classroom was full.
Yeah, so interesting class, to say the least.
Good way to finish though.
Yes, but we're gonna head home and get cleaned up. We'll see you there.
So we're back at our Airbnb. We have just finished our last day of yoga classes at Yoga Barn. Mm-hmm. So 5 days in a row.
And just to recap, we started off with the vinyasa slow, which is kind of just going through the different poses. Core power was the most difficult class in terms of kind of like a workout.
It was also more advanced than any of the other classes that we had taken.
Then we had the yin yoga, which was kind of just like relaxation, very chill, soft music playing the whole time. Mm-hmm. Four was hatha yoga, which is the kind of combination of the different styles. And five was kundalini. That was more of a breathing and meditation type of yoga.
I really liked vinyasa slow. That was really nice. I also thought that because of my mental state that day, yin yoga was also really incredible.
I think my favorite was hatha. As far as just the class goes, going through all the different types, it just basically felt very balanced to me.
I think the one today, Kundalini, which is kind of backwards because there's parts of it that I completely loved, being the chanting part of it, where I completely got into my meditation and was like the only person in the room. But then there was also points where I was like, this is way too much. Like way too much chanting. And the breathing, I mean, I know they go hand in hand, but it was just love-hate relationship there, I guess.
I think Kundalini was my least favorite as well. But again, the teacher definitely had a lot of energy.
A lot of passion. It was a good class. I liked where it put me, but I don't feel like I need to be doing that for an hour and a half.
Going into this, I thought that yoga was just poses. So that definitely opened my eyes to all these different classes that we took where, you know, for example, Kundalini, I mean, there weren't many poses at all that we did today. It also means that however you're feeling that day, you can take a corresponding class to what you want to experience.
What was your experience at Yoga Barn?
I loved Yoga Barn. I think it's kind of an oasis, if you will. Not just one studio, it's it's an area of studios. So once you get in there, everyone is there for the same reason. You know, whether they're going to a core yoga or a yin yoga, they're there to do yoga. Obviously being in Ubud, this yoga studio is gonna be more expensive.
Yes.
Than the other yoga studios. Being in Ubud, there's so many yoga studios that you could attend. If you're on the more budget side, definitely seek those out. But Yoga Barn definitely makes it
a complete and total experience. I was glad that we did it, for sure. Everyone was there for their own purpose. And when you got into a class, There was zero judgment. It's not like anybody was looking at you. You were there for your own mental, emotional, physical growth.
That was our 5-day yoga experience.
I would do it again.
If you enjoyed this video, please make sure to like and subscribe.
And we're going to put Yoga Barn and all their information down below in the description. Make sure you head over to alexanderdenise.com for the blog. We'll see you next episode.
Let's get some booze!
Oh, Jesus.